Hey there, welcome to another Bully 2 video. Since the last video, I've installed this Rocker Dig 2 unit from RC 4-wheel drive, so let's give it a go.
Alright, so we're going to have a look at what the dig function does today. So I've got my two gates here. These two red ones here are gate 1, and the red and the purple make up gate 2. Alright, so let's see how we get on trying to maneuver through the two gates without any dig to start with. Let's get as close to this one as we can. As soon as we're through, full steering lock. Oh, and we're nearly out of bounds already. One reverse will be enough. Oh, don't hit the thing. Oh yes. There we go. We had to do a reverse to get through the gate that time. Let's see if we dig if we can get it done without a reverse. Okay, so we're going to go forward a bit. Going to hit the rear dig. Back into four-wheel drive. Oh, beautiful. It's to my channel 4 position switch here. I'm in the centre as it is now. Car in four-wheel drive, flick it to the back, and the back wheels are now locked, and we flick it to forward, and then the front wheels are locked. Yeah, the Rocker Dig works okay, it's not too bad, it's definitely better than not having one at all. And I'll just hit a gate. Hey guys, can anyone help me out here? So when I engage the rear dig, car goes in a relatively straight line, pulling just the front wheels. And then when I engage the front dig, I'm not giving it any steering input, and yet it just constantly goes round in a circle. And even if I give it steering input, it still goes round in a circle. No matter what I do, you've got circles all the time. Is it because of the battery? The battery is to this side of the axle, so there's more weight on this tyre than on this tyre. Is that why it's doing it? Got any ideas? Good shout.
So, we decided to head back to the beach and try out a bit more actual rock crawling now that we've got a dig fitted. Watching this video back, I can't actually remember the areas where I was using the dig and wasn't. It's not for just crawling around rocks like this. It's not something that you need all the time. It's a pretty specialist sort of tool for certain situations. So it's definitely nice to have, you know. It's another feature to play around with. It still means I roll over from time to time, though. Yes, yeah, I've got a fair few miles on the Bully now. So far it's been pretty good, it's been pretty reliable, nothing's broken on it. One thing I did do was fit some slightly wider wheel hexes to the front wheels. They're 9mm wide instead of the stock 5mm wide. Just gives me a little bit more steering angle. I can actually get the front wheels to turn a little bit more, and it gives me a slightly wider track at the front. Seems to be working out pretty well. And other than that, the only thing I did find was quite a few of the screws had come loose on both the front and rear axles. It does say in the manual and various other places that you should take the axles completely apart and lock tie all the screws in, which I didn't do when I built the thing because I was in a hurry to put it together. So I had to go back and partially dismantle the axles and thread lock all the screws back in again, which was a bit of a ball ache. So yeah, definitely is a good idea to do that while you're building it if you can. The other thing I've done is vented the tyres. I put 4 sort of 3mm diameter holes in each tyre, just to allow the air to come in and out that bit easier, so the tyres can deform and conform to the shape of the rocks easier. And that definitely made a big difference. I think the next thing we're going to try is the knuckle weights. Other than that, I'm pretty happy with the way this thing's driving now. It's a lot of fun on the rocks. So far it's proven to be pretty much bulletproof. Let's hope that continues. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.